What we're going to do now then is to demonstrate the system. Demonstrate the software. And I've got a machine here. I'm actually running a virtual machine under the Oracle VM VirtualBox system, and you can download a ready-made ZFS Storage Appliance server with a whole bunch of emulated disk drives, which is what I'll be doing. But bear in mind, although I'm not really using the actual storage appliance, what I'm doing here is exactly the same as I would on any actual physical appliance. Okay. So there's no difference between what I'm going to show you and what actually happens on a physical machine. So we're going to look at the initial power on configuration, which this thing is sitting waiting for me to start. Part of the configuration that requires knowledge of how we want the disks to be used. Do we want to use something like RAID 5? Do we want RAID 1, which is mirroring? And so forth. And you'll see how we have to decide. So using the different RAID levels, how we want to use the disks, which might depend a little bit on the load that we're going to be using on this system. And then we're going to look at creating shares, including NFS and SIFS, which is Microsoft file sharing. Okay. And I'm going to be doing things like setting up a user account for authentication purposes, a project. Projects are used on the storage appliance to allow us to categorize the shares, for example. So we, you know, when we have many shares and many users, projects would allow us to keep a handle on what's going on a bit better. You can also do things like iSCSI, okay, which is the small computer system interface, you know, SCSI disks, but using the network rather than a data cable. Okay. And when you create an iSCSI share, it will be seen on your server as though it was a physical disk. So the storage appliance can do all the latest technology. Okay. It obviously has lots of management facilities too, and if you already have a database of users that you want to use and DNS servers, then you can point the storage appliance at your Active Directory server, for example, or your local DNS server. And you can authenticate users through an Active Directory interface, for example. As Dave mentioned earlier, we're expecting that you'll already know a little bit about the storage technology that we're going to be talking about. Okay. As I mentioned, management software is the same across all models. We're actually running a simulator inside VirtualBox. If you're interested, you can get VirtualBox under Windows, Linux, and Solaris, but not on Intel hardware, but not Spark. Okay. And the VM image for the storage appliance, for which we will provide a link, can be freely downloaded from Oracle at any time. Just a note about SkillBuilders to let you know that we are involved in this technology by the day. And we've got the resources, we have the certifications and the experience to help you evaluate the products, help you install them, and help you maintain them on a day-to-day basis. And that includes not only the Solaris operating system and the storage appliances, but also some great skills in the Oracle database itself and related technologies. Okay. And if you're interested, then give us a call, and there's a number for you.